Hello everyone, welcome to today's class. My name is Dr. Joshua Aura, and today I would want us to look at valuation models, specifically how to value bonds. And a bonds valuation will be expected to know how to value irredeemable bonds, how to value redeemable, and of course, lastly, how to value convertible bonds. So let us start with question number one that is up there on your screen. Question number one, right? We are told a 12% per annum shillings 1,000 irredeemable bond is to be issued. The bond would attract interest semi-annually, and the investor's required rate of return is 20% per annum. They want us to determine the minimum price of which each bond should be sold. Ladies and gentlemen, the key thing is for us to remember that if this bond will be paying interest on a per annum basis, it means that this interest will be an annuity. And if it is an annuity, I have to be at a position of remembering the PVFA formula, where PVFA will be 1 minus, we have here 1 plus r raised to negative n, everything to be divided by what here? To be divided by r. Now, if the bond is irredeemable, it means that the time of maturity has not been given. N has not been given. We are saying here that our bond is irredeemable. Our bond is irredeemable. And if it is irredeemable, then N is infinity. And if N is infinity, then this term here will be infinity up there, which makes this particular whole term here to be very small. And that is why we normally say that the PVFA, when N is infinity, is 1 over what here? 1 over the cost of capital. Now, in this particular case, then, to get the market value of the bond, where N is infinity, I will basically get its present value. And how do we get its present value? I'll be required to take the amount here, which will be paying every year, times what we call the PVFA. So then this will be amount times our PVFA for an annuity, which is whose N has not been given, which is 1 over R, which will translate to what, my great friends? This will come and translate to amount divided by R. Amount divided by what here? R. But what amount are we talking about here, my great friends? The amount that we shall be paying for this bond, will be the interest, the annual interest. So come and give us the interest. Ladies and gentlemen, they have given us the interest rate, an interest rate of 12%. However, ladies and gentlemen, this bond, interest is being paid on a semi-annual basis. So in this case here, give us the semi-annual interest rate. Semi-annual, that is a half of a year. So maybe a half of 12%, which gives us what here, somebody? Which gives us 6%, like that, every year. So every year, not every year, every 6 months, 6% like that. So then come and give us the semi-annual interest amount. So give us the semi-annual interest amount. This will be equal to 6% of the par value. 6% of the par value. 6% of the par value, 6% of the par value, so 6% of the par value. 6% of the power value, which will be 6% of the farm's power value, which is 1,000. So ladies and gentlemen, this will end up giving us shillings 60, shillings 60, shillings 60. So every year, shilling 60, shilling 60. Now from there, I would want us to discount these using the annuity infinity model. Annuity infinity model, I would want to come and give them the present value, knowing very well that our N is infinity. The concept of 1 over R, the concept of the interest all over R. So the interest per annum that you guys have given me is shilling 60, and then the required rate of return, the required rate of return is 20%. But remember that 20% is for a whole year. And in our case, the compounding is on a semi-annual basis. So come and multiply this denominator by half. So then this will be like 60% divided by 10%. 60% divided by 10% gives me a present value of 600, which as well happens to be the market value of the bond, which happens to be the market value of the bond. So I want to believe that that has been beneficial, and then allow me to go to question number two. So for question number two, what do we have there? Question number two, it is James Chiwende. James Chiwende is considering the purchase of a 5-year shillings 2 million par value bond. The bond has a coupon interest rate of 8% per annum. The investor's required rate of return is 8%. So they want us to give them the current value of the bond. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a redeemable bond. It is a redeemable bond. Why am I saying it is a redeemable bond? It's because they have given us the maturity period. Maturity period is 5 years. Maturity period is 5, so it's redeemable. After 5 years, we shall pay back the money. So if it is redeemable, two things. Give me the interest per annum. Interest amount per annum. The interest amount per annum, what do we have? They have given us the coupon interest rate. They have told us in this second line, if my admin will be able to show you there, they have told us the bond has a coupon interest rate of 8% per annum. So then this will be 8% of the par value. 8% of the par value, which is 2 million. So we have here 8% of 2 million. So 0.08 times 2 million, which will give us 160,000 per annum, like that. And we shall be able to pay this 160,000 every year. For how many years? For 5 years. Every year for 5 years. So because of the uniformity, then this automatically becomes an annuity. Listen to me very well. Here we shall be having two types of cash flows. We shall be having the interest over 160,000, which is an annuity, which then has to be multiplied with what we call the PVFA. And then, ladies and gentlemen, if I'm the investor who has given this company this money, every year I will be getting 160,000 every year, an annuity. So for discounting purposes, I have to multiply this with the PVFA, and then I can foresee something. That on maturity, when the bond matures, I will be paid back my entire power value that I gave. So in this case here, we have another form of cash flow called the power value. So the power value, which has to be redeemed in full, is 2 million. So this 2 million is a lump sum amount. A lump sum amount that we'll be receiving in 5 years' time. So because it's a single lump sum amount, it's not a series of figures, it is a single lump sum amount that we shall be receiving in 5 years' time, we need to come and multiply this with the PV, with the PV, with the PV. And therefore, ladies and gentlemen, I would want us to understand this and understand this very well. The total value of this redeemable bond, the total value of my bond, will be equal to, I will take this 160,000 multiplied by the PV part plus we have 2 million multiplied by what here somebody PV, multiplied by PV. Total value will be gotten by us looking at the benefits, the cash flows that we shall be getting, the interest plus our redemption value, So come and give us the PVFAR, how many years? 5 years, 5 years. What is the firm's cost of capital? The firm's cost of capital, if my gentleman here could show you these, they have given us a required rate of return. It's question two. They have given us a required rate of return, which is 8%. Required rate of return is our what here? Is our cost of capital. And because it's PVFAR, please remember the formula. It is 1 minus 1 plus R raised to negative N, everything to be divided by R. So then this will be 1 minus 1.08 raised to negative 5, N is 5 years, divided by 0.08. Please give us a figure there. So then this will give us 1 minus 1.08 raised to negative 5 equals divided by 0.08, which will end up giving us 3.9927, like that. 3.9927. So this is the figure that I'll plug in here. How about PV for the lump sum? One off figure. The PV, ladies and gentlemen, for the one off figure, PV is very easy. It is 1 plus R raised to negative N. So then this will be 1 plus our R required rate of return is 0.08 raised to negative 5. So then this will be 1.08 raised to negative 5, which will give us 0.6806, like that. 0.6806. So now come and plug in here. So what we have at the end of the day, ladies and gentlemen, this is what we shall be having. At the end of the day, this will be 160,000 multiplied by our PVFAR, which is 3.9927 plus 200,000 multiplied by our PV present value interest factor of lump sum amounts is 0.6806, like that. So please come and give us this parameter. What do we have here? We have 160,000 times 3.9927 plus 200,000 times 0.6806, which at the end of the day gives us 774,952. That automatically marks the value of that particular bond. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let us look at this very well. Yep, I've seen something here. This is supposed to be 200,000. Supposed to be 2 million. This is supposed to be 2 million. Please rectify there. It's supposed to be 2 million. Because you can see here, 2 million. So if it's 2 million, let us rectify that. If it's 2 million, so we have here 160,000 times 3.9927 plus 2 million times 0.6806,
which will give us 2,000,032. 2 million, you can repeat again, 160,000 times 3.9927 plus 2 million times 0.6806 equals, which gives us 2,000,032 as the market value of the bond as per the question. The question wanted us to ascertain the market value of the bond. Market value of the bond. Let's go to question number three. Question number three. Question number three. If you're able to see it on the screen, question number three, what do we have there? Ngatia Limited has issued a 20-year bond with a nominal value of shillings 1,000 and a coupon annual rate of 9%. Coupon payments are made semi-annually in arrears. The yield to maturity of the bond is 12%. This yield to maturity of the bond is what I will be using as my cost of capital. So my cost of capital is 12% for a whole year. So they want us to give them the value of the bond. They want us to give them the value of the bond. Value of the bond. They want us to give them the value of the bond. They want us to give them the value of the bond. If I could be captured on the screen, writing here. So question number three. Question number three. Ngatia Limited has issued a 20-year bond with a nominal value of shillings 1,000 and a coupon annual rate of 9%. Coupon payments are made semi-annually. Please underline for me there, semi-annually in arrears. So if it's semi-annually, then I have to get my interest, which now will be semi-annual, every 6 months. That will be a half of what? The rate given there is 9%. So this will give us 4.5%. So you are told here coupon payments are made semi-annually. That is why I ended up using a half there. The yield to maturity of the bond, so the cost of capital, which is the yield to maturity, is 12%. 12%. But ladies and gentlemen, here we have to do what? Here, somebody, we have to prorate it half, which is 6%. The other thing is N. They have given us 20 years. But remember, you are paying this particular interest every 6 months. Every 6 months. So then we need to double the period. Because every year has got two semi-annual periods. How about 20 years? 20 years. So you have to talk of 2N. Like, so 20 times 2, which gives us what? There's somebody, which gives us 40. Which gives us 40. So they want me to give them the value of the bond. It's very easy. What I need to do is to come and give them the interest per annum. The interest, we know the coupon rate is 4.5% of the par value. So this will be 4.5% of the par value. The par value is 1,000. The par value is 1,000. So 4.5 times 1,000, 4.5 times 1,000 divide by 100 will give me 45 bob every year, every period. For how many periods? 40. So then straight away, ladies and gentlemen, come and give us here the PVFA, because this is an annuity. So give us the PVFA. So how do we get PVFA? Now you guys have known the concept. It is 1 minus 1 plus R raised to negative N. Everything to be divided by R. So then this will be 1 minus 1 plus our cost of capital. Our cost of capital that I'm using here is 6%. So 1 plus 0.06 raised to negative N, which is negative 40 there. And then we have everything being divided by 0.06 like that. So then what do we have at the end of the day? We have 1 minus 1.06 raised to negative 40 equals divided by 0.06. Which will give us what figure? 15.046. So this gives us 15.046 like that. The other thing that I know that is quite for sure here, for sure here, ladies and gentlemen, there is what we call the redemption value. Here, because they have given us the maturity period, which is 20, so there is a redemption value. There is a redemption value. There is a redemption value. So the redemption value, what we have here? Redemption value is the par value. Is the par value, which is 1,000. And remember, this will be received at the end of the 20th year, which is the 40th period, remember. So in this case here, we need to discount this using the PVIF. PVIF at 6%, 40th period. So then this will be 1 plus R raised to negative N. This will be 1 plus R, which is 0.06, raised to negative 40. Raised to negative 40. So then this at the end of the day will give us what parameters? We have 1.06 raised to negative 40, which will give us 0.00972 like that. Now, ladies and gentlemen, having gotten those two parameters, now I'm at a very good position to discount this. I'm at a very good position of discounting these parameters for me to be able to get the market value of the bond. So the market value of the bond will be equal to the interest, which is 45. This is to be multiplied with the PV that we have obtained, plus the redemption value, which will only come once, multiplied by the PV. So then this will be 45 multiplied by the PV that we have here, which is 15.046 plus 1,000 times 0.0. 1,000 times 0.0 times 0.0972 like that. So could you kindly give us this figure? Kindly give us this figure. So we have here 45 times 15.046 plus 1,000 times 0.0972, which at the end of the day gives us 774.27 as the value of that particular what year, that particular bond, as the value of that particular bond. Question number four. So you're told there, Safaris Limited is currently issuing a 9% bonds at 100 par value in 5 years' time. So it's a redeemable bond. Alternatively, each bond may be converted on that date into 20 ordinary shares of the company. The current market price per share is 4.45, and this is expected to grow at the rate of 6.5% per annum for the foreseeable future. The company's cost of debt is 7%. They want us to give them the market value of the bond. So market value of the bond, will be equal to the interest annuities. Interest annuities multiplied by PVIF plus the redemption amount. Redemption amount multiplied by what here, somebody? Multiplied by PVIF. So two things I need to get, ladies and gentlemen, I can see quite easy marks that I need to pick and put somewhere. Yeah? For example, I can read the PVIF. I can even compute the PVIF. How many years are we talking about here? 5 years. With what cost of capital? The cost of capital is the one that has been given there before required. The one that has been given there before required, they have told us the company's cost of debt is 7%. So 5 years, 7%. So this will be 1 minus 1 plus R raised to negative N, everything by R, divided by R. So ladies and gentlemen, at the end of the day, come and give us these parameters, we store them somewhere. We want to store them somewhere. So this will be 1 minus 1 0.07, because R is 7%, raised to negative 5 equals, divided by 0.07 equals. So let me hide this figure here. This is 4.1002 like that. Also the PV, if I need to get the PV. So the PV, which I need to get here very fast, I know the formula of PV is 1 plus R raised to negative N. So this will be 1 plus 0.07 raised to negative 5 years. So this will be 1.07 raised to negative 5. Raised to negative 5, which will be 0.713. 0.713, like that. So come and hide this figure here. 0.713, like that. Thank you very much. So slowly, I need the interest amount per year. I need the interest amount per year. The interest amount per year, what do we have there? Interest per year, interest per annum. They have given us the coupon rate. They have given us the coupon rate. If you read that question very well, they have told us Safaris Limited is currently issuing 9% bonds. So 9%. So it is 9% of the par value. Don't forget that. 9% of the par value. So this will be 9% of our par value, which is 100, which will give us what, somewhere there, which will give us 9 more. So fix this figure somewhere here. The interest per annum is 9. Now we are left with redemption value. And unfortunately, this is a convertible. It's a bond that has got conversion element. They're telling us, ladies and gentlemen, so I'm now looking for the redemption. I'm now looking for the redemption. The redemption that I have here, they're telling me that the current, or rather, alternatively, each bond may be converted on that date into 20 ordinary shares of the company. 20 ordinary shares of the company. So I need to know the market price per share. The current market price per share is 4.45, and this is expected to grow at the rate of 6.5% per annum for the foreseeable what year future. Remember there, I have to get the market price per share at the date of redemption. So we are told currently, this thing is going for some principal amount, which is growing. So in this case, if it's growing, then I need to get this market price per share using this formula of compounding. So we have here our market price per share at the time of redemption will be equal to our current price per share is 4.45. So 4.45 into 1 plus the growth rate of this market price per share, which is 0.065 raised to the power of 5. So then, ladies and gentlemen, at the end of the day, this will be 4.45. This will be 4.45 times 1.065 raised to power 5, which at the end of the day gives me 6.0969. But now remember, these are shillings per what? Per share. And during redemption ourselves, we shall be given, in this case, we shall be given the total value of ordinary shares. We shall be given how many shares? They have told us 20 shares. So we have there 6.0969 times 20, which will end up giving us 121.938 like that. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I have the redemption value. Why? Because when it comes to redemption, I'll ask myself, where am I better off? Just releasing the bond, I get 100, or I convert this bond to ordinary shares and I get this amount. Of course, I'd always go for the higher amount. So therefore, the redemption value is this 121.938. So meaning, ladies and gentlemen, that at the end of the day, I'll be able to get my market value as interest, which is 9, times 4.1002 plus the redemption value, which you have settled on this figure of 121.938 times 0.713. So then come and give us this figure honorably. Honorably, what do we have at the end of the day? So we have here 9 times 4.1002 plus 121.938. 938 times 0.7513, which at the end of the day will give us 123.84. That is the value, the market value of your convertible bond. The market value of your convertible bond. Now look at part two of this question. Part two of this question, ladies and gentlemen, Roman 4, they want us to give them the floor value of the bond. The floor value of the bond. Remember, floor value of a bond, ladies and gentlemen, will be the smallest value of this bond that we can obtain. The floor. Floor means lowest, the lowest value of a bond. And the only difference between this and this floor value is that for the floor value, we shall consider the lower redemption amount. Remember, we had a choice to work with either 100 or 121 like that. So in this case here, for floor value, you work with 100. So for floor value, work with the lower, work with the lowest possible redemption value, which is basically the par value, which is 100. Every other thing remains the same. The interest here will not be affected. So at the end of the day, we'll be talking of 9 times 4.1002 plus 100 times 0.713 like that. So at the end of the day, please give us a figure. What do we have there? So we have here 9 times 4.1002 plus 100 times 0.713. You'll be able to give us 108.20108. So we have here 108.2018. That is the floor value. And then they want us, ladies and gentlemen, to give them the conversion what year? Premium per share. They want us to give them the conversion premium per share. The conversion premium per share. So conversion premium per share will not be a big deal. Why? Because we have our conversion value. So Roman 3, we have our conversion value at the end of year 5. At the end of year 5, the one that you took the current value, you had it growing. And then if I can remember very well, times 20, which gave us 121.938. So come and compare this, ladies and gentlemen, with the current market price per share for all the shares that you have. The current market price per share is 4.45. And remember, we are talking about how many shares? We are talking of 20 shares. So we have here 4.45 times 20 shares, which will end up giving us 89. Now, because of the option of converting, I can see some profit there. So the profit is 121.938 minus that answer, which gives me 32.938. But now remember, this is premium for what year? For all the shares. And the examiner is categorical. He wants you to ascertain the premium per share, which will be 32.938. We divide this by 20. So divide this by 20. What are we getting at the end of the day? It's approximately 1.65. So ladies and gentlemen, I'm to imagine that you have enjoyed this lesson. Please share this particular clip on YouTube. Thank you very much.